Let's start with what I'm most excited for, the gun I carry, and an extra battery. So the gun I carry is a Bluetooth smart cube, meaning you can connect it to your phone and time your solves via that, and also play online with other people. And so let's just look into this. So first things, there's this card. And then on here, looks like we got a GameCube badge. I'll add that to my collection. Looks like we got some extra spring sets, and I think those are GES nuts. And then an empty bag. Looks like it's for the preset springs on the cube. And then instruction manual. Have a million of these. But let's go onto cube. If I can open it. Okay, there we go. So this is the GAN I carry, like I said. It's got these different notches for the GAN robot, if you have that. I do not have that, so. It's got like a, I think it's more of a matte finish. And so let's do it from the first turns. So out of the box, it feels really fast. So I might see if I can glue it, although I'm not sure, 100% sure if I can. Might look that up. But it seems very fast out of the box. And fast is not really what I like. I like a lot of controllable cubes. But yeah, it feels pretty good. Let's see corner cutting. You can cut 45 reverse. Reverse is decent for a cube. And I saw, yeah, there's a light blinking. It probably has something to do with connecting to the app. So let's get that open. Okay, so here I have the cube. And so I'm going to go ahead and connect it to my phone over here. So it says that I need, I need to get the light blinking, and then tell it to search, and yep, that I think that's it. And so it's connected. I'm gonna hold it in the position it shows there. Yeah, and that, wow, look at that, that's cool. Okay, so I'm gonna go play a match or something, maybe do a couple solves, and yeah. So first thing is training. I'm gonna try out training. Practice solving cube freely and improve your scores brilliantly. In algorithm, you could not only enjoy a great algorithm library, but create your own libraries. That's cool. In timer, you could freely customize the ending status of scramble and solve. Choose the mode you like and start training. Okay, I'm gonna just go for timer. Here you could choose your starting status. Here you could choose your ending status. Support timing certain steps like F12 only, OLL, MPL, etc. That's actually kind of cool. So I think what it means is I can solve my cross in F12 and then it counts the solve as done. So that's pretty cool. You could group your solves here in view details by tapping the little icon on the right. That's cool. Here records some information of the current practice. Tap scramble to start. Okay. So casually do a U prime to start. Okay, so I'll follow this scramble right here. I guess I get 50 seconds of observing. That's strange. So I guess I just start whenever. Not the best cross. Giant pause right there. Okay, that wasn't exactly a great solve for me. So it says here, 12% cross, fluency index of 62. No idea what that means. F2L, 46%. I think that's pretty accurate. Second pair took a lot longer because I did have a big pause right there. And then OLL, not very much, and PLL is pretty decent. So that makes sense. So I'll confirm, and I'll do it again. And also, it looks like it hides part of the scramble so that you don't, like, I guess you don't write it down and cheat, I guess. So let's start here. That was a much better solve for me. So, not as much as for cross. I did better on that. F2L was a lot more, like 50%. First pair took a lot longer, it looks like. 3 seconds for our first, and then the rest were about a little over 1.5 seconds. And then OLL, not very much, and then PLL, about the same. So I'm going to do a couple more solves on this, and I'll let you know how it feels. Ah. Bit of a block up there. So it looks like I did do my first F2L pair before my last cross edge, because I wanted to preserve it. And it looks like it says I got a skip. That's cool. So I guess it considers it an X cross, maybe. So let's just do that again. Okay, so my average of 5 is 19.494, which is a little bit more than what I average. Probably because I'm not exactly used to the turning of this cube and whatnot. So, yeah, I'd say that's all for the timer. I'm curious what double cube is, but I feel like I need 2 cubes. Okay. Algorithm. Let's look at that. Oh, that's cool. So it teaches you. These algorithms look like these are beginner algs. Let's see. CFOP. Let's look at PLL. So, UA. Yep, that's the same algorithm I use. H. I did U primes instead of U's. I just find it easier to do that. And then Z's. Again, I also do U primes instead of U's because I find it easier to do. And then I use different A perms. I mean, let's do an online match, I guess. Here you could play against cubers from around the world. In time trial, play and upload your results in global ranking, which update weekly. That's cool. Qualifying. 1v1 real-time battle with other cuber. I'm probably gonna do that. Here, all kinds of battle modes are waiting for you. Come on, enjoy yourself. Okay, I'm gonna go to qualifying. Oh, wow. Season 21... No, S21 season. So I guess I'm just gonna do multiplayer. Please stay tuned. Okay, solo. Matching. Okay, so I'm playing against Jacob, and it looks like I probably need to give myself a name. It looks like they changed it from 50 seconds to, I messed up on a cross. Uh-oh. Connection failed. Okay. Cool. So it looks like I beat them. What are they doing? Well, it looks like they're about to get a DNF in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And I won! Yeah! Woohoo! Victory! So I did 71 moves, that's not the best for me. 3.7 TPS and 72 fluency. I guess that means I got a C. Okay, well, that's all for the game I carry. Let's move on to the next thing.
My next puzzle is the calendar cube V3 4x4. So this is basically a cube, but it's a calendar. So it displays different months and whatever. So it looks like it's scrambled right now. Oh, no, it's apparently New Year's Day. January 1st, 2023. So there's all these different things you could do. So I'm gonna try to solve it to today's date. Okay. Well, it took me a while, but I did figure it out. So today is June 3rd, 2023 of Saturday. It's probably not gonna be that date when this video comes out, but yeah, calendar cube is pretty cool. So next puzzle. Now the next cube is this tiny GAN 330 keychain cube. And so might as well try it out. I'm probably not gonna put the keychain on, and it's definitely not magnetic. And so the first turns, it's very quiet. And it feels actually pretty good for like a really small cube. For reference, let me see if I can find my other small cube. So these are my only other small cubes. This one is the world's smallest Rubik's Cube, although definitely not the smallest. They are much smaller. I actually tried playing Lube in this one and it made it turn a lot better. And then this one is just some crappy off-brand cube that barely turns. And then compared to this one, oh yeah, this one is very smooth. Nice and loose. There's no magnets, obviously, because how are you gonna fit those in there? But yeah, this is actually a pretty decent cube that for its size. And then it's also got this keychain. So I guess I can, ooh, that's kind of cool. It's like a rubber. And boom, got a keychain. It's actually pretty nice. And now, you've seen all these tiny, small cubes, right? But get ready for this. It is an 18 centimeter giant Rubik's Cube. So let's just take this cube right here. And like one piece on this cube is about the same as a normal cube. That is crazy. And I know there are much bigger ones out there for sale. But I figured this one was a nice start. And looks like we got an instruction menu here. No idea what it's telling me to do. Whatever. Well, this thing is kind of dirty. It is very, very like dry. Maybe I can put some lube in it. Although that's probably not the best idea. Probably need to wipe it off because it's got a ton of dirt on it. Let's try doing an algorithm on it. There we go. That is a T-perm on a big cube. Gonna do the left-hand version. Boom. And that is a giant Hishu 18 centimeters cube. And here is the Gan 330 compared to it. It's very tiny. So that concludes the unboxing. I hope you enjoyed. I know I did. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.